Hey y'all, Rick Sky here, back again with another video. And within this video, and I'm going to go ahead and flip over here to this other camera so you can see. So I'm going to do a COVID test. Now I'm not a doctor or anything. I just everybody in my house has COVID, and I don't. So I'm going to test again and see if I've got it. So we're just going to go through this. This right here is called the iHealth. So this is the particular kit that I'm going to use. So it says, prepare materials, open the package, take out the COVID-19 test card. Excuse me. So this is that package here. And take out the COVID-19 test card. Oh, that's fancy. Look at that. Wow. Okay. Yeah, I've been using another type, and this is my first time using this type. So, God, that is fancy. Okay, so it says, take that out. And I'm gonna move this back right there. Okay. Take out the test card, and let's see. Collect sample. Open the pouch. Take out the COVID-19 test card and pouch. The tube filled with the extraction buffer and swab. When you're ready, proceed with the test. Open the full pouch of the test card. So that's what I did. Step two is collect sample. It says, remove swab from its package, being careful not to touch the tip of the swab. Please swab the package for later use. Okay, so I don't want to touch the tip. So looking at this, here's the tip. It's got the little, you know, like cotton or whatever on it. So I'm going to pull this out. Okay, remove the swab. Okay. Before I take it out, I'm going to read this. It says, gently insert the entire absorbent tip of the swab, usually 1/2 to 3/4 of an inch, into your nostril. It says, firmly and slowly brush against the inside nostril, a circular motion against the nasal wall, at least 5 times. Take at least 15 seconds to collect specimen. And da da da. Let's see. I'm reading ahead before I start doing this because I don't know if there's a timer on it. Firmly and slowly brush against the insides of the nostril in circular motion against the nasal wall at least 5 times. Take at least 15 seconds to collect the specimen and be sure to collect any nasal drainage on the swab. Using the same swab, repeat collection for the other nostril. And you know, it says use the same swab for both nostrils. Okay. Okay, so we're going to do that now. So I'm going to rub this in my nostrils for about 15 seconds around. Here we go. I'm going to do the other one. I'll do it as thoroughly. Okay. Okay, now it says process sample, tap tube vertically. So it's tapping on this bottom, not the orange part, but the. And twist the large orange cap to open the tube. Okay, so I'm doing that. Insert the swab into the tube and touch the bottom of the tube with the top of the swab at least 15 times. 1, 2, 3, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, it says, squeeze the sides of the tube to express as much liquid as possible from the swab. Okay. And stir at least 15 times. 1, 2. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So I'm just rubbing this in there in that solution. It says if you don't squeeze the swab, there may not be sufficient sample material to perform the test properly. So if you don't squeeze the swab, so I'm squeezing here. Screw back the large orange cap and put the swab. Let's see. So I've done that. So now I think you've seen I've done that super thoroughly there. So it says screw back the large orange cap and put the swab back in the package. So I'm going to put this back in the package. And then I'm going to put this orange cap on. And now it says, twist open the small white cap of the tube. Add 3 drops of sample port of the COVID-19 test card. Okay, so I'm going to add 3 drops. See right here where it says 3 drops? It says add 3 drops of sample to sample port on the 19 test card. So I'm going to unscrew this. And I'm going to add 3 drops. One, two, three. Oh, okay. That's got 3. Screw the small white cap on. Okay. So now what we do, wait 15 minutes. Start the timer. Click and start timer, blah, blah, blah. Let's see. I'm going to set my timer for 15 minutes. So there's, well, actually, I'm gonna go up just another minute. Why not? Okay, so I got 10, 15, a good 15 minutes there. We're gonna come back in 15 minutes, and we're gonna see what we got. Okay, so I'm going to keep it covered for dramatic effect here, but we are very close. Look at that. We're getting close. I'm going to let it, you know, I'm going to do the full 15. And again, I may have given it just a minute or so over 15. I was, you know, kind of anxious to get this thing done. And let's let this get back to the 15-minute mark. And while that goes, I'm going to keep this covered. And I just want to talk. So, yeah, so everybody in the house, you know, everybody's got COVID and they came back positive. And when I found out daughter had it, I took a COVID test and I came back clean. Now, then, you know, my wife took a COVID test and she came back dirty. So my daughter and wife both have the COVID. And then I took this test and we're about to see what we got here. Okay, so I think it's fair enough. We can reveal the result. Ooh. Okay. Let's see here. It says test explanation. Let's look and see what we got here. Okay. Let's look at the results. Below are positive tests. Below are photos of actual positive tests. Please note the T line may be faint. Okay, so a negative result. Okay, so here we go. Positive result right here. So here you see it. It says C and T have a line. Okay. I got a Charlie and a Tango. I got a Charlie and a Tango there. Okay. Yeah. Yep. And I didn't want to spoil the surprise on the video because I wanted to wait the 15 minutes to do everything just like it told me to do. But within seconds of putting those three drops on there, I noticed both of these lines emerge. And you can see here that, according to this diagram and this test, that I am COVID positive. It says a positive result must show both a C and T line. A positive result means that viral antigens from COVID-19 were detected and the individual is positive for COVID-19. So without further ado, let's go ahead and flip over here. So, I mean, obviously, I'm being responsible, and I'm not, ever since I found out that, that our daughter had COVID, that she, got the positive COVID test, I've kept myself away from everybody. So, I'm not out potentially spreading this. The biggest thing here, for me will be this calls for this. This is the Ronza Kappa, and this is a Sistema Solera 23. This is a Guatemalan rum. So this is definitely something. It says from virgin sugarcane honey and aged at high altitude, Solera, Gran Reserva. Gold award of 2000, 1999, 2001, 2002. And it says, in the Sistema Solera, art and tradition encourage the blending of rums of different ages and personalities so that they may continue to mature in select barrels. This dynamic and artisanal process culminates only after the complexity of aromas and flavors confirm that unique mature rum has been created. Zacapa 23 is a unique balance of complex aromas and flavors resulting from the special blend of reserve rums. We hand select rums aged between 6 and 23 years for our Sistema Solera. Older and younger rums are then blended as they age in a sequence of barrels that previously stored robust American whiskeys, delicate sherries, and fine Pedro Ximenez wines. Aged above the clouds, Zacapa rum is aged in the cool air of the Guatemalan highlands, 2,300 meters above sea level, allowing the rum to mature more slowly in the barrels. Similarly to cooking over a low flame, these conditions allow Zacapa to obtain exceptionally deep aroma, rich color, and profound flavor. So, it is worth mentioning, with this positive COVID test result, what should I do? And I think that definitely calls for a what I'm just going to call a cleanse, and have some of this really high-end Ron Zacapa that I haven't, I've had this for many years. Did I buy it in Jamaica? Or did I buy it in St. Kitts? It was somewhere in the British West Indies. I can't remember exactly where I bought this, but I've been saving it. And this would be a good time to taste that. Now, I did want to talk about my COVID. So now I'm confirmed COVID positive, but I wanted to talk about my symptoms. And, basically, I've kind of had a sniffly nose. I've had one night I had a fever. It was really, really intense. And then the next day it was just a mild fever. It was probably 99.9 or something, below 100, which was still significant. But, and again, I'm not a doctor. I'm just sharing my journey with y'all. So in my voice, you can tell my voice is kind of scratchy. And I haven't been as high energy. Normally, here on Irish Guys Adventure Channel, I've got to create content, tons of content. And I've been a little, my energy level has been low. And I've kind of had a low-grade headache. And, it's not a normal headache. It's just kind of a headache I've never had. So, obviously I'm going to keep my distance from people. But at least now it's good that I know I have COVID, because that means I can move throughout the residence. And because see, I was avoiding I was avoiding my wife and daughter because I didn't test positive. And, you know, I did have a fever, and like, what if I had something different? You know, I didn't want to give them something on top of COVID. But now that I've got COVID, I guess we got the whole COVID crew, I guess. But Ron Zacapa. Yep, that calls for this. I've been saving this for, you know, saving it for something. So this is a good excuse to tap into the Zacapa. But it is worth mentioning, though, my taste, although I can taste, my taste is kind of distorted. So I'm almost tempted to enjoy a lower tier rum. When I say lower tier, I mean lower price point. In case, yeah, I don't know. I may take at least one sip of this just to taste it, but part of me doesn't want to because my taste buds are messed up from COVID. So I'm gonna have to find something else. But anyway, that's it. Just want to let y'all know, man. You know, the proof's in the pudding. You know, no tomfoolery here. I mean, this is a positive COVID test. So, yep, it is what it is, man. Oh well. Thanks for your viewership, and be sure to subscribe. And I'm going to continue to pump out the videos again. I'm a little bit scratchy, and now I know why I'm scratchy. So, anyway, thanks for your viewership and your support, and y'all have a good day. Be safe.
Hey, y'all, Captain Irix Guy here. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. If you did, please be sure to subscribe. It's youtube.com/IrixGuy. And ring that bell icon when you do to be notified whenever I post another video. Thanks for your viewership, and y'all have a good day.